welcome you all to the first lecture of the grammar course. So today we are going to talk about a fundamental concept, and we often say grammar start from this fundamental concept. Just let me just have you remember that your body consists of certain parts, and we have been learning since our childhood about parts of body. So let's just have a journey towards the body and say our hands have something, our ears are something, our legs are something, and every part of body has a different function. If I say our hands are used to hold things, our hands are used to eat something, our hands are used to clap, and then our legs are used to walk. We use our ears to hear or listen, and we use our eyes to see beautiful things all around. So all our parts of body have different functions. Similarly, in grammar, we have parts of speech, and to make our speech effective, we have to use these parts of speech. Again, there is a very, very important thing to remember. It is not important that all parts of speech will be used to make your speech. There can be just one part of speech as well, like I say just go. Only one part of speech is involved in this sentence, go, come, stop. So let's understand these 9 parts of speech which are used in grammar as the basic root foundation of language. So the first part of speech is noun. The second is pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, article, interjection. So looking at these 9 parts of speech makes us journey through the grammar course, and we need to learn them in detail in the next videos. So let's first understand what are these 9 parts of speech and how are they functioning in grammar and how are they functioning in speech. The first part of speech is noun. Now what is a noun? To understand it, to put it in simpler words, we say noun is a name. I have a name, you have a name, this city has a name, your business has a name, and then your things around you. Just look around you and see all things present around you. All have names. Your children's school have names. And then your teacher has a name. Your boss has a name. Your company has a name. So everything around you has a name. And there is nothing in this world which exists without a name. And that naming word is a noun. Next comes pronoun. Now pronoun, the name itself defines, that is used in place of a noun. When I say a noun is a person, place, thing or idea, and then when I use in place of a noun, what I'll be using? If I say Sam is a good boy, Sam is a very naughty student, Sam studies in 8th standard, Sam is the only son of Mrs. Jan and Mr. John. So this is how I am putting Sam and Sam again, and you will find my speech boring. So just to avoid this boring effect from my speech, I have to definitely use a better word. So I will use a pronoun in place of Sam, and I will use he. So again, I will rephrase my speech saying Sam is a good boy, he is a little naughty, he is the only son of Mr. John and Mrs. Jan. So this is how I use he in place of Sam. And had there been a girl in place of Sam, I would have used she. So for males we use he and females we use she. So he and she and many other like I, we, you, it are called pronouns, which are basically used in place of nouns. Next comes verb. Now when I put it in more simple language, verb is an action. Verb is something which you do right now. What you are doing? You are listening to me. I am speaking. You are sitting or standing. I am standing. So all the actions which are involved from the very moment when we wake up in the morning and the time when we go to bed, whatever we do is verb. So really you don't need to remember about verbs. So whatever you do, you play, you run, you walk, you smile, you go, you come, you enjoy, you listen, you speak, all these are verbs. But then there is not important that only actions are involved in the process of verb. There are certain state of being also which we call as verbs, like state of being involves when you say I am a student, I am a teacher, she is my friend, like they are our neighbors. So when I'm using the words like I, is, am, are, was, were, will be, all these are state of being. And some sentences like the sun rises, the rises, it happens by itself. No action is being done by you. So these words come under state of being. And next important part of speech which we have in part of speech is, that is adjective. Now adjectives, when we talk about adjectives are describing words. Now what do they describe? Your teacher sometimes appreciates you. Sometimes your boss gives you a well done kudos saying you are a good person, you are a wonderful boy, or else your mom can scold you saying something, you are really bad. So the qualities can be described in a positive way or in a negative way. So when this quality is given to a noun, it can be given to a thing also. This is very small, this is very big, this is large, this is small, or else in terms of colors, I'm wearing a green dress, you may be wearing a particular color dress, size, shape, structures. When we tell the qualities of persons, places, things, that means nouns, we say these are all called adjectives. And then next comes the most important part of speech is adverb. Adverb, the word itself signifies, it actually is related to the verb. When an adjective describes about a noun, an adverb will always talk about verb. An adverb will always tell the quality of a verb, of my action. If I say I'm running fast, so fast is associated with my action that is running. She is writing slowly, so slowly is again associated with the action writing, not with the person. So when the quality is associated with the action, with the verb in a sentence, it is called adverb. Next important part of speech is preposition. Prepositions are relationship words in a sentence. When you say, I am going school, I am coming school. So we definitely need some relationship words to connect the verb and the noun. So when I say, I am going to school, I am coming from school. So all these actually make my speech clear. So to and for here are prepositions, and there are many other like of, by, of, all these words are called prepositions. So next comes conjunctions. Now what do we call a junction? What is a junction? We all have heard about junctions. Junctions basically connect the railway platforms with each other. So junction is a point which joins actually. You have joints in your body. Your joints also join various nerves and muscles in your body. So junction is the place or the point which connects. Similarly, conjunction is a part of speech which connects. It can connect two words. It can join two group of words or two phrases, or say maybe group of words, or it can connect two sentences. For example, if I say John and Kelly went to the market. John and Kelly went to the market and bought some oranges. So I'm connecting the sentences and the words by using and. So and here is a conjunction. I'm speaking and you are listening. So two actions are taking place and these actions are connected by, these sentences are connected by and. You can even connect to contrasting opinions. Contrasting means two opposite ideas. I will go to Shimla, but he will go to Delhi. Again, but is now connecting two sentences which are opposite, which are contrasting to each other. So these are called conjunctions. And in other words, they're also called joining words, linkers, connectors. And the next important part of speech is there is article. Now, articles are three in English grammar, that is a, an, and the. And a, an are called indefinite articles. And the is called definite article. When you point towards a non-specific thing, I met a girl in the park. Of course, that girl could be any girl. And probably it's not the specific one. When I say, I met the girl who won the first prize. So basically, the represents, the actually specifies the girl in that particular point where she won the prize. And a talks about just any non-specific person. And same goes for an. I got an egg plant, or I'll say I had an archer in my colony. So these all are indefinite articles and the is definite article. Then there is a concept of zero or no article also. Sometimes we don't need to place an article before nouns. So we need to know the perfect rules of a understanding which we will learn in future videos. And the last but not least part of speech is interjection. Now what is interjection? When I say interjection, it expresses an emotion. You can express your emotions with various words like wow, wonderful, or else you can say hey, and then you say oh my god, you know, oh gosh, oh my god, OMG. All these words always carry an exclamation mark at the end, and these are called interjections. So here comes to the end of your first step of English grammar, that is parts of speech. In the future videos, we are going to learn more details about each part of speech.